Hello folks, and welcome back to SnowRunner. We're going to play a little more of the game's hard mode. And I did a couple of things. I was looking at a few of the different options that were available. And I did find in the settings for... where was it? The Crane Navigation Legend. So I've been complaining about that for a while, that I wish that would go away because I really don't need it. And we can actually turn it off. So I have turned it off. We'll see how that works. Matter of fact, we'll go test it out now. Head over here to the Western Star. And give me just a minute. Twitch is having a couple of issues coming up. I think a lot of it has to do with my internet connection. Or maybe just my computer. There we go. Now we're up and running. So let's jump in the White Western Star. And I need to... my anchors down, and it has turned nighttime on. Oh yeah, I like that. So no more crane menu. And see if we can't pick up some of these logs. And I had some of them shift forward, so. Yeah, that didn't work. Trying to pick up too many at once. Let's try it like that. That almost. Almost had three. All right. I think once I get a few of them off here, I'll be able to load it better. Or unload the truck a little easier. Yeah, it won't work for now. I am slowly unloading it. So unlike other cargo, if I were to pack this, it would pack all of them and then not leave me any more. So I've got to take off six and only leave three. space them out a little bit. Oop, I lost him. Move my truck around a little bit. Yeah, it might be okay. How many do I have left? I got 4 left. Let's get one more off. Yeah, that didn't look like it worked too well. There we go, it's a little bit better now. So I need to separate these two a little bit. I got you now. And I gotta release it in order to change trucks. All right, 3 logs, packet placed unevenly. Oh, I'm gonna have to move all those back. Alright, that's not pretty good. Start with these two. I can't pick them all up. crane. Well, get the crane out of the way. And see if that'll work. Got butt crazy. Oh, come on. I don't think the logs that are sitting out here are the problem. Because that should not affect loading the truck. Back a little bit further. See if that'll work. And pack. There we go. Oh, you need to get the mission up here. So this mission was. Timber at arm's reach, I believe. Nope. It is the timber for the locals. That's the one. All right, that's one. Here. Let's try to clean it up. Yeah, that's not cool. I get up. And I'm pretty much. Alright, I think this one is next. Looked even there for a second. And one more. One nearest. I should have went a little harder. Straighten that up a little bit. And we'll see what happens. Come on. This is kind of a pain in the butt. Both of these at the same time. I think that one might be okay. My luck, I would pack it, and then with the cranes in the way, it would knock the truck over. Alright, keep packing. There we go. Alright, one more to go. I think it may have something to do with it not being even there. I don't know. And spin you around. Put him a little further back this time. Yeah, it's gonna drop. Get a better bite at it. Yeah, a little bit better. Thank you. That's 2, 4, 4. And the last one. And change your truck up. Excellent. All right, so that one is done. And all I have is medium logs left. And plenty of gas. So the farm and town storage. I think I'll do town storage first since I'm over here. Yeah, let's go ahead with that. Alright, so I'm gonna do basically the same thing. I'm going to bring over 6 logs, but I'm gonna do it a little differently this time. I'm not going into the town storage. I'll sit out in the road and then keep taking the truck. We will see if that works. Also see if the medium logs will stay on the trailer or if they will bounce off. Got plenty of fuel. I believe I will park it right here. This should give me plenty of room on both sides. So, who did we have? That. The Pacific. And I did put logs on you, right? Yes, I did. Be such a wonderful truck with a bigger fuel tank. Yeah, I'm going the right way. Second, I thought I was going the wrong way. I do need to slow down. I don't need to bump into something and then all the logs slide forward. That would be bad. So still on the hunt for a car for my daughter. Seems like people around here that are selling cars want 10-15% above book value, as there is a used car shortage here in West Virginia. And people selling them think that since there is a shortage, they can charge whatever they want. We looked at one at a car dealership, and nice little car, a Subaru, was it WRX? And I like the car. I would have liked to have gotten the car. They're wanting. I'm going to lose. Alright, I have to come back and get them. I will probably lose a few more. Should have slowed down. Anyway, I like the car, and quoted me a price on it, and I checked it out on the internet, and they are wanting $2,000 more than the car is worth in perfect shape. This car is not in perfect shape. So I called the dealer back and explained that to him and see if they would come down on the price, and he said nope, the price was non-negotiable. There is a used car shortage and they will sell it for that price. Yeah, he had to find some other sucker then. I'm not buying. Don't seem to have a lot of new cars running around here either at the car lots. Checking on those also. And even new car prices are skyrocketing. And they don't have much of an inventory. So the hunt continues. I remember the first car that I ever got, 72 Buick Skylark. This was back in the early 80s. So I traded a go-kart, I think it was a go-kart for the body, and traded a mini bike for the engine. Drove it for several years. I'd like to have that old car back. I took it someplace I shouldn't have. I was up in the woods running around on some trails in a car, which was really stupid. But I was young and dumb back then. And ended up, I rolled it over. And it bent the frame. So I bent the subframe on it. So I had a buddy of mine, his dad had a junkyard. And I was just going into the army at the time. Said, just leave it with me. Said, next time you come in, I'll have it running. Okay. So I was away for a few months and got a call. He said he had it fixed. I could come and get it. And I showed up to pick it up and I cursed him for an hour. Because what he did was he couldn't find a frame. So he ended up mounting it to a Ford pickup frame. So I had a four-wheel drive 72 Buick Skylark. Not a happy camper. Had it about a week and blew a tire on it. Had big mudders on it. And I was mad. And at a gas station. and just lost my temper and took a tire iron to the car. Hit it a couple of times, and there was a guy at the gas station said, instead of beating it, won't you sell it to me? Like, buddy, you got the money and I'll sell it right now. And he had the money. So I went down to my first duty station and met a guy down there that had a car for sale. I was at Fort Stewart, Georgia. Wow, all those almost fell off. But the car was in California. And me and somebody were just talking about this today. And being young, he was getting ready to go on vacation. It was in, he had it in where his family was from, Malibu, California. And he was driving back, so I rode with him and bought the car sight unseen. Just jumped in it and brought it back to Georgia. Didn't even know if it'd make it. But it turned out it was a really good car. 76 Chevy Malibu Classic. Had that one for years until I went to Italy. Couldn't take it with me, so I left it at home. My brother borrowed it. He was in the Marines. And went down to a town near us, and him and some friends were sitting between buildings revving the engines, and he ended up blowing the motor. So he had it towed back to his mother-in-law's house and went back down to Camp Lejeune. Came in 2 weeks later, was going to put a motor in it, and she had already called a junkyard and had it towed away. Tried for a while to find it, but no junkyard would admit to having it because it was a really nice car. I figure it's still on the road somewhere. Oh, now I get three. So I got one of you up. Move around the least. We'll have to go back and get the other one. Oh, I spun it around too much. I'll go back the other way. What is going on with the camera? I am not moving a camera. Now I am, but it was moving on its own. All right. Come on. Stop engine. Trucks, and will you load your pack? Yes. I don't know why a guy keeps parking that car there. I hit it every time. I think he'd learn by now. should be able to go this way. And then back around without having the crane bind up. Got to get centered so that we pack right. Barely have that one. Just cleared it. Medium logs are a lot easier to load. He moved it. He always does. These two up, and I'll go back after the other. Yeah, that'll work. Held on just long enough. Grip. And let's back you up. And go get one I dropped. Now we'll drive off for a little bit, save a little bit of gas. So I did find out from my self-imposed hardcore mode that if you lose a log and it's on the side of the road, it doesn't go away, it stays there. So I don't have to worry about the log disappearing. Even if I jump to other maps, other regions, come back, the three logs that I lost are still there. But they were last time I checked. Actually, don't remember how far up the road I lost it. Might have lost it before the gas station. Thinking maybe I should have put the crane on the other truck. But when I lost it, I could have picked it up. I remember now, it was after I hit that. I went from the road to the mud up here. Jogged it loose. There it is. Sitting there waiting on me. Nobody cut it up for firewood. Medium log, I'll need the anchors down. Get a grip on it. See if that stays. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I better try to secure it a little bit. Stop. Let's see if it'll stay like that. In fact, I go in high gear so I don't jostle it around too much. Looks pretty stable though. I doubt if two would stay this good. You know, now that I think about it, I wonder if medium logs would fit in the three cargo sideboard add-on bed. Put a bunch of them in that. It might keep them in there better than using a log trailer. That might be an idea. Alright, we're too slow. Might regret this, but need a little more speed. So you think you're pretty sure that the log pointing straight to the back of Bob's head is a safe thing to do? I would do that if I was driving, but Bob is driving, so. I'm sure if Bob didn't like it, he would say something. Give him a hard hat. Yeah, I don't think they're wearing hard hats. That could be a mod. Put a hard hat on Bob. I want to hit something now and see if the log will go through the cab. I don't think that'd be a good idea, especially since I have to pay for repairs. Alright, let's go a little further up. There we go. And do my anchors this time. So I'll be going out further. Bob was perfectly safe. OSHA was not around. Smart man would have sat it down and got a better grip. And pack it up. awesome. Almost hit the pizza sign. Man, pizza sounds good about now. And luckily I can't damage a trailer. Alright, three more logs to go. And I think I'm going to have to buy fuel at the fuel station. Oh yeah, the dog mod. I used to have the dog mod. It was the only mod I would run. Just so Bob would have somebody to talk to. $8 a gallon. Okay, I like that. Which means I will fill up some fuel tankers before I jump to Alaska from this gas station. The fuel add-on tankers. Because the fuel over in Alaska is expensive. And if I fill it up here at $8 a gallon, it'd be cheaper than 12 or 24 gallons over there. Which I still need to test that. If you have your fuel tanker full and you jump to a new map, a new region, is it still full when you bring it out of the garage? I might want to test that and just put a little bit of fuel in one and jump it over and see. Hey Nathan, how you doing today? Got a problem with my other TV, so I can't see the chat unless I turn my head to the right. I may have to get another TV. So if I don't see the chat, I'm not ignoring y'all. Sometimes I forget to look to the right. And I'm sitting here in the easy chair with a heating pad on my back, standing all day teaching. Got my back a little bit sore. So I think I want to try something. See if it'll work. So that one gets the longer bed on it. And I think I want to try to put that longer bed, because I'm going to have to buy it anyway. And try to carry the medium logs on. Well, one, two, three. Probably couldn't carry but six. I might be able to stack them. Yeah, let's save that for another time. down. Yeah, we'll save that for another time and do an experiment with that. I really want to get that truck back to the garage and get a bigger engine for it. That little engine just isn't working. You, however, your engine runs pretty good. I was also looking because I would love to buy the HX. But that thing's like $172,000. I don't have near that money yet. Tried. Oh, you haven't tried? Still in Michigan? Oh, that's right. Nathan, I saw you were on Cosmodrome. How is that map? I just saw a little bit of your playthrough. I've been trying to avoid watching the playthrough so that I can experience it without knowing anything. So is it rough, or is it like Imandra rough, or just like the regular map rough, like over in the Yukon? Down the road. Okay, this next delivery point is at the farm. It's not that far away. So I think I'm just going to load the logs and make three trips.